January 20, Feast of the Santo Niño. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the Feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed its days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances. But not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished, and his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth, and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age, and favor before God and men. The Gospel of the Lord. Did you not know that I must be in my Father's house? Whether he must be in the Father's house, which is the temple, or he must attend to the Father's business. Jesus fulfills the mission entrusted to him by the Father. One way to seek God's will begins with familiarity with the Mosaic law that has been the standard and guide of Jewish life for centuries. Jesus dialogues with the teachers and elders in the temple area, much like a young Jew coming of age and earning his bar mitzvah. Luke often uses the temple area as a stage where God's mysteries and kingdom are unveiled. In fact, his gospel story begins with the announcement of the birth of John the Baptist to Zechariah, who is serving at the temple. It ends with the tearing of the curtain of the temple sanctuary, exposing the Holy of Holies kept inside. It is Jesus who opens the Holy of Holies with his death and resurrection. Jesus then returns to Nazareth, growing in wisdom and age under the watchful eye of his mother Mary. An understanding of the faith begins gradually with the catechumenate, acceptance of faith in baptism, and full adherence in confirmation when the child comes of age in the circle of the Christian family. As we Filipinos celebrate the Feast of the Santo Niño, we recall the gift of faith when an image similar to the infant Jesus of Prague was given in 1521 as a baptismal gift by the explorer Ferdinand Magellan to Raja Humabon and his wife. Since then, the image has attracted devotional processions and pilgrimages, with numerous Filipinos touching or kissing the image of the child Jesus in veneration. To commemorate the 500 years of the advent of Catholicism to Philippine shores, the Archdiocese of Manila spearheaded the 9-year program, dubbed as the Philippine Conference in New Evangelization, or PCNE, in order to rejuvenate the faith and mission of the Philippine Catholic Church. The PCNE events serve as the response to the call for new evangelization, a new way of being church, to be a missionary church serving the poor members of society. The Catholic Church needs to confront the emergent powerful culture affected by developments in information technologies, new media, and social networking that influence the people's way of thinking. Through the PCNE, the Philippine Church wishes to attain 3 goals: to create an experience of God in the context of the new millennium, to strengthen bonds of communion, and to inspire the faithful to live by the spirit of mission. To stimulate this renewal process, lay people and the clergy are engaged in dialogue, sharing stories of faith in the context of the modern generation. Learning the faith and practicing it expresses the vibrancy of the young Christian community growing in wisdom and favor within the ambience of the family of believers.